Hi viewer, I welcome you to Dream TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies, form 2, lesson number 14. The topic it is warehousing. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mugen. Welcome. Our lesson objectives today, we are going to identify the various types of warehouses and also explain the advantages and disadvantages of each type of the warehousing. In our previous lesson, we managed to look at the two types of the warehousing, that is the private warehousing and the public warehousing. And today, I want us to look at the two others, that is the boarded warehousing and the free warehousing. We start by looking at the boarded warehousing. Now, when we talk about the boarded warehouses, are public warehouses meant for keeping important goods? Get this? They are meant for keeping important goods as they wait payment of the customer duty. So, before the payment of the customer duty, the goods are stored in the boarded warehouse. These are goods that are imported from other countries. So they come, get to the port, then they will be stored there in the warehouse, the ones that we are referring to them as boarded warehousing, as they wait the owner to pay the custom duty. So you need to pay that customer duty in order for you now to get your goods released from the boarded warehouses. A board, let us see what is a board. Is a guarantee that the goods cannot be released before payment of duty is made. A board means that this is an agreement. This is a guarantee. If at all you get that your good is kept in a boarded warehouse, it means that you must pay a specific duty for that commodity to be released. That is the kind of boarded warehouse that we have. You can see the commodity are stored there. There are a variety of them. We have a number of them as they wait for the owners to pay the custom duty. What are the features of the boarded warehouse? Goods can be boarded until custom duty is paid. That is one feature. So goods are not released there until the custom duty is paid. Number two, goods can be re-exported. If at all the owner fails to pay that custom duty, then it means they are going to go back to the person who sent the good, re-exported back to the country where they are coming from, or to the owner who sent the goods. Number three, storage charges are made on all goods stored. So you must pay the charges of storage. Apart from the custom duty, even the charges of storage you are going to pay. Number four, goods can be sold while still under board. Goods can be inspected or prepared for sale still in boarded warehouse. And then, goods are released only on the production of a release warrant after paying the custom duty and storage charges. What are the advantages? Goods can be prepared for sale, that is one. Owner can look for the market for the goods before paying the duty, that is number two. Some goods will lose weight, hence lower custom duty is paid. So if at all you know your good will lose your weight as it continues to stay in a warehouse, then you wait for it to lower the weight in order for you to pay less custom duty. Number four, burden of paying duty goes to the buyer when goods are sold while still under board. So what happens, a point where now the owner gets the buyer before getting goods from the boarded warehouse, it means that that burden of the custom duty, it is going to be served or it is going to be dealt with by the buyer. Number five, goods are secured from risk. Number six, goods improve in quality. Advantages to the government, source of government revenue, you can get that they are paying the custom duty. Number two, ability to control the entry of harmful goods, so they are able to control that. Number three, verify document for goods in transit. Then ability to control quality and quantity of goods entered into a country. Number five, ability to inspect type and nature of goods imported. Number six, ability to check the illegal goods entering the country. Disadvantages. Importers may fail to pay the custom duties, leading to auction of goods. Number two, withdrawal of goods in bids may cause the importer to pay higher custom duty. Then, the importer incurs costs in hiring a boarded warehouse, even if he or she has his or her own private warehouse. You need to pay for it. Free warehouse. These are warehouses in which tax-free goods are kept, awaiting sale or correction by the owner. These are tax-free goods. Note that locally produced goods are stored in free warehouses since no custom duty are paid for them. So this one, it is the place where you are going to produce goods locally. As you wait for it to get market, then it means that you are going to do it. You can be able to see how they are kept. Advantages, owners of goods stored need not pay any taxes. Then it is cheaper to store goods. Number three, they are located on convenient places for the customers. Disadvantages, government does not benefit. Number two, checking and security of goods is not guaranteed. Activity, explain the advantages of boarded warehouse to an importer. Explain four advantages of boarded warehouse to the government. Reference, you can get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can get us from the Facebook. And you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Erim TV. Thank you.